United States and Poland have proudly executed this new enhanced defense cooperation agreement. I know it will lead to good outcomes for each of our two countries and the work that we all do as part of NATO as well. It paves the way, centrally, for an additional 1,000 troops into Poland on top of the 4,500 that are here presently. That's an important strategic move for American security, too.
In 25 years, we have not seen this type of success, this type of agreement between Israel and an Arab state. What do you see under President Trump's leadership? You see peace between a Gulf state and probably more to come, and with Israel.
We're committed to helping Iraq achieve economic prosperity, freedom from foreign meddling in its internal affairs, and improve relationships with its neighbors as well. This is what the Iraqi people want too, a stable, prosperous, independent Iraq, an Iraq which is for Iraqis. We touched on religious freedom, a priority for the Trump administration and a key to the Iraqi nation's flourishing. As Iraq moves forward from the ISIS persecution and genocide, the U.S. is helping the most vulnerable, including Christians, Yazidis, and Shabak, recover.
For 3.5 years, we've imposed cost on China in a way that has protected the American people from this threat. And when they refused to acknowledge the Wuhan virus, when they said, we're going to cover this up, we're going to allow people to travel across the world in spite of the fact that we know it presents a threat, President Trump is aiming to hold them accountable for the enormous loss of life all across the world and the trillions of dollars in economic harm that the Chinese Communist Party allowed to permeate all throughout the world.
This process will lead to those sanctions coming back into effect 30 days from today. Our message is very, very simple. The United States will never allow the world's largest state sponsor of terrorism to freely buy and sell planes, tanks, missiles, and other kinds of conventional weapons. These UN sanctions will continue the arms embargo.